Hello. Welcome back to another episode of Rebecca Reviews. Today, I'm here to talk to you about this. The Witches of Oz. This is a terrible, terrible movie. It was a waste of nearly 3 hours of my life that I cannot get back. And I am one of the most emphatic Wizard of Oz fans that I know. I love everything about it. I love the books. I love The Wiz. I love Wicked. I love the original movie. I love everything to do with The Wizard of Oz. Tin Man was genius. This is tripe. For over about three and a half hours, you take it on this magical journey where Dorothy is a little girl grown up into a writer moving to New York to sell the Oz books. Okay, no problem. Real interesting premise. I'm down with that. And you come to find out that everyone in Oz was transported to modern-day New York or Kansas, as she starts out, and they've been made to forget that they were ever citizens of Oz. Okay, real interesting premise. The problem is they don't do crap with it. What ends up happening is that Dorothy becomes this whiny little, I'm not the girl from the books, I'm not the girl from my memories, blah, 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 blah. The Scarecrow is her best friend, and the best line in the movie has to belong to him when he finds out he's the Scarecrow, at which point his legs are torn off. And he says, I always knew there was something different about me. I just thought I might be gay. This is the best line. Originally, I watched this movie because Christopher Lloyd is the Wizard and Billy Boyd is Nick Chopper. That's one identity that's never addressed really by any of the Oz franchise sequels, etc. I'm really excited about it. And Billy, oh sweet dear Billy, I am a pervy Hobbit fancier from way back and you are so much better than this. Why, Billy, why? He doesn't even end up being the Tin Man. He's just named Nick Chopper. The Tin Man comes out of nowhere. No explanation, just all of a sudden they are kicking ass. The robot effects are kind of cool. And Christopher Lloyd is sadly misused as the Wizard. You see him only in flashbacks. He's on screen for about 1 minute at the very end where he plays an off-key, so public use, version of Over the Rainbow. It just goes nowhere. It has no bearing on anything. I've heard that the theatrically released version entitled Dorothy and the Witches of Oz is about an hour shorter, with about 15 minutes of footage that's new and a whole bunch of new special effects. This I can understand. You could easily cut over an hour from this movie and lose nothing. Absolutely nothing. It was a waste of $10. It is a sad, sad entry into what is such a beloved series, and it could have been good. It really could have been. The premise of stuff from a fantasy world coming into our world, yeah, that's been done a million times, but not with The Wizard of Oz. It could have been fantastic. And to see it reduced to just this claptrap that explores nothing and goes nowhere is just depressing. I'm Rebecca, and unfortunately, I'm still reviewing it.